Kenya. Before this, children affected by the disorder were beaten, hidden away, or killed because it was believed they were possessed by demons. Now, luckily, over the past few years, autism awareness has slowly spread throughout the country. And at this time, joining us in studio to talk a bit about this is Mitch Malako, an activist with Autism Lights. Mitch, welcome to the program.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for finding time to be here with us today.
Thank you.
Only recently, autism spectrum disorder has become recognized in the country. Before this, we've heard about children being beaten, killed, hidden away. Tell us a little bit about the stories you've had in relation to this as you've carried your work, carried out your work.
Thank you so much. Autism, in the month of April, we evaluate as Autism Awareness Month, and we focus on basically creating respectful, positive, and accurate information about autism. And this actually we share with our family members, our co-workers, who might happen to be people on the spectrum, as we call it ASD. ASD mean autism spectrum disorder. Autism basically is a developmental disorder that affects the child's ability to communicate and interact with others.
Okay. Yeah. We actually have some graphics with the definition, which we'll be putting up on the screen in just a bit. We've tried to simplify the definition of autism spectrum disorder. It refers to a range of conditions characterized by challenges with social skills, repetitive behavior, speech, and nonverbal communication. In terms of statistics, some statistics carried out, or a survey carried out in 2007, showed that it affects approximately 4% of Kenya's population. Coming back to you, what more can you tell us? Do you have any new statistics? What are the numbers you're hearing about in terms of autism in the country?
Currently in Kenya, 1 out of 46 kids has the disorder, the ASD disorder. That's the autism spectrum disorder. And I'm basically here to place light to people and change the dialogue about autism from fear, pity, and tragedy to support acceptance and empowerment. Okay. Not only awareness, but to create inclusion and acceptance about autism.
What sort of activities are there in this month of April, which is Autism Awareness Month, to kind of let Kenyans know more about how to help those who have autism, for example?
Basically, being an ambassador and an activist for autism in Kenya and Africa at large, I work for a non-governmental organization that's Autism Lights, that's based in the United States of America in Boston. So we have a couple of events in April. April is basically Autism Month, basically to create inclusion and acceptance about autism. So we have our first event that's coming up at the Bomas of Kenya this 14th, that will be on Saturday. And I'm inviting all parents, kids who are on the spectrum, to basically come and share and, you know, just have a good time.
How does a parent who has a child with autism help that child to be the best they can be? What sort of life skills do you teach them?
We have in place referral schools that we can refer parents to, and we have therapists in such schools. So the therapist will basically help them in regard to how the child will be able to communicate, talk, and interact with others in school. So all you're basically advocating for is inclusion. Yes.
Okay. Who are you working with, on this campaign? Have you brought in, I did see some pictures, you've brought in some influencers, you're trying to raise awareness. Who are you working with, and what are you hoping to achieve by partnering with some of these personalities?
I've worked with couple of Kenyan celebrities and personalities, to name just a few, Nazizi. I've worked with DJ Mo. Of late, I'm working with Kenya's hip-hop rapper, Calligraph Jones. I'm basically, myself, as an activist or as an ambassador for autism, I'm doing this through music, and I'm engaging them through their music to create awareness on autism. And quite indeed, I have a lot coming up in the month of April, and I know Kenyans will love it.
A lot of interesting things are going to happen.
Yeah.
In 2003, the government of Kenya passed a Disability Act, under which it is an offense to conceal or imprison those considered mentally ill, etc. Do you think that has made a difference? As you've been doing this, are you seeing more parents coming out and saying, I think I have a child with autism? What sort of response do you get as you go around, the country, sharing this message?
I think in regard to autism acceptance, it requires both a shift in our action and in our minds. Mm-hmm. Because people with ASD or the autism spectrum disorder, they are normal, but they behave or rather interact in ways that some of us might judge them in a particular manner, which is not the case. Yeah. So I'm here to basically create inclusion to them, and I'm sure that the government is actually, they're striving a lot to put in place inclusion in schools, in our government schools, and in private schools as well, for kids on the on the spectrum.
What more needs to be done? You have said so far, at least there are improvements, we are seeing changes, more acceptance, but what more needs to be done? And in fact, because you said that you work with an NGO that's based in the States, how has America dealt with sort of autism and helping bring about acceptance? What examples can you give us?
I'd say this for a fact that the government and through the organizations that I've worked for, we've created a lot of awareness campaigns. Barely a week ago, we had a walk in Kisii about autism, and I'm pretty much sure that word is actually reaching out to people, and we're starting to accept these kids because they are our family members. Some of them are co-workers, some of them are our friends, some of them are partners. So I'm pretty much sure that with the kind of work that we're putting in regard to creating inclusion mm-hmm. and awareness, mm-hmm. the government will fully and has fully supported this. And this, I'll say for a fact that last year, Her Excellency, the First Lady Margaret Kenyatta, I remember her in her Beyond Zero marathon, she mentioned something on autism, and that really touched my heart. And I'm pretty much sure that they are willing to support courses that are geared toward creating awareness and inclusion on autism.
Okay. County governments, with the advent of devolution, what more can they do? We've come to a point in Kenya where we say, let's stop really focusing on the national government, but try and see how we can bring about change in the county governments. You mentioned Kisii. What else? What other activities can you say you're doing in other counties as well? Apart from Nairobi, where almost everything seems to be happening.
Exactly. So, meanwhile, we're focusing a lot on in Nairobi in particular, but we're trying to diversify our campaigns to different other counties. Talk for instance, Mombasa. Narok, and the rest. We're looking for county governments to come in and partner with us, and we'll bring in ideas definitely on how we can engage them in regard to our campaigns and our awarenesses that we're creating out there. So I'm pretty much sure that several counties have seen what you've done in Nairobi, and all that is coming up actually in Nairobi, and I'm sure that several other counties are willing to like work with us.
Okay. Yeah. Let me give you a final comment. What would you say to those watching, those who may have children with autism? What sort of encouragement, guidance can you give to them, you know, on behalf of the organization?
Basically, autism, it's not a disease. Autism is not a disease. And these are our kids. These are our families. And in regard to creating the awareness about autism, these are people who really must accept and live with them. And I'm pretty much sure that the kind of events that you have in April will basically enlighten families and support parents.
Okay.
We also have one of a kind, we call it a BCBA training. In East Africa, we only have one BCBA, that's Puja.
What is BCBA?
BCBA basically is a training to parents in regard to how best they can handle their kids and you know, treat them, help them learn how to walk and talk. So we have one kind of a special training in Kenya on the 27th of this month at the All Saints Cathedral. So I'm pretty much sure with all this kind of awareness, parents are pretty much enlightened on what we're doing and what I'm doing personally as an activist.
So if I want to know more, Bomas of Kenya this weekend.
Yes.
27th All Saints Cathedral.
Yes.
And your website is?
You can check us out on our website at www.autismlights.org.
Thank you so much.